One-on-one, never lost. Went to the finals, never lost.
You never got there, LeVar.
Who?
You.
I've been a one-on-one champ. Never lost one-on-one.
All right.
Back at it again, it's the guy Spencer. You know what time it is. It's time for the top 10 East Texas players of the week. This is the last week of the regular season. A lot of big games across East Texas this weekend. A lot of upsets, a lot of big blowouts. Surprisingly, weren't supposed to be blowouts, but nonetheless, either are the top 10 players of the week. So starting at number 10, we've got a sophomore cornerback out of Longview, Texas, Willie Nelson. Had 7 tackles, a tackle for loss, and 2 interceptions, and a big 49-0 win over Tyler High. Tyler High struggled without Eli Holt. They've been struggling without Eli offensively. Here's Derek McFall, the sophomore. He's going to throw one up, and Willie's just going to run underneath it and make a great catch on it. Kind of just sees the ball, goes and tracks it, and it's the intended receiver right there. Here's an overthrow. McFall, Willie catches it in there. He's going to take it back about 27 yards all the way down to the 3-yard line. He also had a big punt return. That was for a touchdown, but was called back because of blocking the back. But just watch this kid move and elusive. A great play by Willie Nelson. At number 9, a losing quarterback in Sam Peterson from Lindale. You know, I usually don't pay attention to the guys that lose, but this guy threw for over 300 yards, 3 touchdowns. He also had 3 interceptions, but they went back and forth with Kilgore. And if he doesn't turn the ball over as much as he did, they'll probably win this football game. This is a district matchup, district rivalry. These two are probably on course to meet each other again in the playoffs later on down the road. And Sam Peterson did play well. Despite the bad throws, despite the bad decisions that cost him the game, he did play well. He moved the football up and down the field. Can't pay attention to the score at the top of the screen because Huddle didn't quite get that right. But he executed the offense, moved it up and down the field, scored on a very tough Kilgore defense. I'm interested in seeing this matchup one more time. I think Lindale has what it takes. I think they have a good coaching staff, and I think they have what it takes to be around round 4 when these two could possibly meet up again. Of course, I think Kilgore is going to be there. Their tremendous run game, and I'm very interested to see a part 2. I hope for my own viewership that we'll get to see a part 2 between Lindale and Kilgore, because these two had an absolute classic Friday night. A bunch of scores. And the thing is, with all the scores that they had, defense still was, you know, the deciding factor in the game. And so it's always interesting how these two, when they get together and how it play out. They've had some great matchups over the last couple of years. It'll be very, very interesting if these two can get it on one more time, this time in the playoffs. Here's a hook and ladder they tried. I always hate it when that one guy doesn't throw it back to anybody. Hey, man, move the ball. But anyway, at number 8, Demarion Van Zandt, the quarterback from Kilgore, at 9 of 14 for 229 and 3 touchdowns. And let's start off with a dime. My goodness, what a ball that was to, I think, Roney Jr. that was. But Van Zandt, he plays clean football games. He's not going to throw for 300 or 400 yards because Kilgore runs the ball and they're very good at what they do. But he does a great job of just playing off of play action and just delivering great shots. Look at that one to Isaiah Ross, who was hero, last week's hero against Athens. He catches a 69-yard and takes that one to the crib. Van Zandt is a great operator. He's very accurate. He can throw it deep. I like this cat. I think he can play. And I think he's going to be a big reason. And he's maybe not the main catalyst. Davin Rider obviously is the guy on Kilgore. But Van Zandt is going to be a great piece of what they do, and if they make a deep run this year, I think Demarion's going to continue to play great football week in and week out. Went score for score with Lindale. I know Davin Rider had the huge game, but 9 of 14 for 230 and 3 touchdowns. That's a great efficient game, and they're telling you he does a great job of managing the game and getting the ball when it's his time and opportunity to throw. So, big game for Van Zandt as he gets the ball out to Roney. Roney's doing a little rack after that. Here he is in the gun. And you can see he's just, I mean, these aren't special throws. They won't be on the highlight tape at the end of the year, but it's a great job of just playing efficient football in the middle of the game. So at number 7, a running back from Mount Pleasant, Edward Wilder. He had 8 carries, 232 yards, and 5 touchdowns. Now, Jacksonville has struggled this year, no doubt, but that doesn't mean anything to Wilder. He's going to take it out on him. 8 touches, 232 yards, 5 touchdowns. I mean, only 3 times he ran the ball, he didn't score. I bet they hated seeing 14 line up in the backfield. Doing a great job on the buck sweep. Scoring right here. I think they're going to run another buck sweep right here to the left. Great job by number 66 getting out and blocking and kicking out. And Wilder is going to do the rest. There's another one. He's an even longer one, a 68-yard touchdown run. Same kind of buck sweep principle. Spins off of one. And he could go all the way. Not my best Chris Berman impression, but nonetheless, number 7, Edward Wilder. And number 6, Jermaine Roney Jr. 4 catches for Kilgore, 145 yards and 3 touchdowns. And then he had an 88-yard kickoff return for a touchdown to keep the heroics going for Kilgore. Kilgore's got it, man. They got the running back. They got a couple of receivers. They got a great quarterback. They got an offensive line that is willing to block and open up holes. And they got a good defense. Well, They got a tough defense. A tough defense. They've given up some points this year, but I think they've got enough to get it done on offense for this group to probably host a trophy at the end of the year. I'm really liking the Bulldogs the more I watch them week in and week out. Here's Roney catching it. Good rack yards right there. And here is the kickoff return to open the third quarter. And I always hated when teams have the smoke out there in the middle of the game. Like, come on, bro. Like, I hate it when we do it. I don't even think we do it anymore. Boom! Truck stick. Wow. Get out, Roney. Cuts up. Okay. And look at the blocks all the way down the field. Look at the effort by the entire special teams unit. Number 17 and 22 blocking 60, 70 yards down the field for a kickoff return for a touchdown. That's a huge team accomplishment. At number 5, quarterback from Jefferson, Chris Bowman, threw for 440 yards and 4 touchdowns, ran for about 60 more, and had 2 more touchdowns as Jefferson and Atlanta go to war and have an overtime game, and Jefferson wins 42-36. Jefferson and Atlanta not been very good this year. Atlanta hasn't been very good at all this year, but they actually had some equal talent out on the field, and they had a great little duel between themselves. And Bowman, huge game, managed it well. You see, he can send the ball out to his receivers quickly. Spread offense that depends on getting the ball out quickly. And he did a good job on Friday night, going for 440 yards. And these spread passes, these are basically run plays. They just happen so fast, and the quarterback gets the credit for the yards. But here's a 69-yard touchdown pass he's got coming up. And I can't tell if it rained Friday or if the grass is just that bad. But what a dime that is. Hits him on the run. Stop. And pop and score that thing. Great job there from Bowman to Dylan Washington. Big 69-yard touchdown pass. Here he is. He's going to hit Eli Burns. Pumps the bubble. Throw it up to your guy. Moss action. Doesn't score, but a good pass there. At number 4, Brandon Tennison, the senior quarterback from Gilmer. 27-34 for 361 yards and 1 touchdown. Just did an absolute job of managing the game, getting the ball out of his hands quick. Here's their patent screenplay to Rohan Fluellen. He's going to get busy and get a whole bunch of yards. Underscore this one. But that's been a very good play for Gilmer over the past couple of years. That little toe screen to Rohan Fluellen. Here's another one, getting the ball out of his hands quick to Fluellen again, making guys miss. He's really good at that. He can catch the ball in space and make the first guy miss almost every time. Here's Tennyson in the pocket. Deep ball. And hits number, I don't know who that is, but that's a great throw. Hit the guy kind of in stride. Had to slow down a little bit, but that's a great throw, great completion. Not a lot of quarterbacks in East Texas can make that throw. Great throw on a flag route to Fluellen. Moss in the end zone. Good ball placement. Here's a 42-yard pass. This one's going to Fluellen as well. Great air under the ball. Leads the receiver. Perfect spot for him. At number three, Cayden Fortson from Sabine. No highlights here. He had three interceptions. His first one was a pick six, and that big upset win for Sabine over Tatum, 28-27. So shout out to Cayden Fortson for having a huge game. Get some highlights up, man, so I can use it. At number two, 10 catches, 202 yards, and a touchdown, Rohan Fluellen. Not only did he go off on offense, he had an interception on defense. He had a huge punt return. He's Gilmer's number one best receiver on the team. He's a guy that's going to have to make play after play after play if they're going to make a deep run in the playoffs. And he did last year, and he's probably going to do it again this year. And I can't wait to see what him and Tennison cook up in the playoffs this year. Here's the interception. Sees the flag route, judges it, goes up and snags that thing out of the air. Great interception. First down, Buckeyes. Three is in the slot. What do we got for us? This must be the flag route. Yeah, sticks the flag. Good spot. Goes up and snatches the ball away from the defender. Touchdown, Buckeyes. Here's the punt return. He does a great job of making the first guy miss. Maybe not a great job of covering that kick. You gotta go smoke that guy. But gets in and out of traffic great. Gets tripped up at the last moment. And then here's, we've seen this cut before. But here's the YB. Gets inside and it's a clean release on the flag route. Great spot for Tennison. First down, Buckeyes. At number one, the best player from last week is Davin Rider from KILGORE. 24 carries, 319 yards, 5 touchdowns. Then on defense, 6 tackles, and just 2 interceptions. My goodness, Davin Rider is trying to earn his number one spot for the player of the year this year. He's been going crazy all year long. He's been running the hell out of the football. He's got great speed, great top-end speed. He's been running by people all year. Then on defense, he makes big hits and interception after interception. You know, he's playing both ways of the ball. He's the biggest catalyst and the biggest reason why KILGORE finishes the season, I think, out at 9-1, and probably the biggest reason why I feel like they can win a state championship this year. Davin Rider has played absolutely great, and y'all don't need me to commentate on the rest of this. Just watch the greatest that is Davin Rider. Had a huge night in 62-55 win over LINDALE. Can't wait to see these two. I think they're going to get it on here one more time, and I can't wait to see what Davin does throughout this entire playoff run. And hopefully he can get the KILGORE Bulldogs all the way to the state championship.
Yo, YBH.